the first thing that hit me as far as the Kennedy assassination was when I was 3 years old, and a man in his 80s who owned a walnut orchard that was next to our property where we were living in Van Nuys, California. He just came up to me in front of my dad, and he came over and he gave me a Kennedy half dollar, and he said, "This was a great president," and he started crying, and it shook me up a little bit because, you know, you don't, as a little child, you don't see 80-year-olds cry in front of you very much, and so it really hit me that there was something really tragic that had happened to this man on the coin, and I still have that coin, and I've held on to it all this time. And that kind of stuck in the back of my mind that there was something really tragic, and I wanted to have a better understanding of it. And then later in life, I decided to take a closer look at it. While it is often assumed that the HSCA Forensic Pathology Panel, a panel of 9 prominent experts hired by the U.S. House of Representatives to help them in their investigation, cleared up these mysteries, a close examination of the testimony of Dr. Michael Braddon, the panel spokesman, reveals this isn't true.
When Kelly and I were alone in the hotel room, he showed me a small picture of the back of a man's body with a bullet hole in the base of the neck, just where the autopsy surgeons said Kennedy had been shot. I never mentioned it officially.
Because if the wounds had been in the back, as depicted in the autopsy drawing, the bullet would have entered too low on Kennedy's back to have exited his neck and hit the man sitting in front of him, Governor John Connally, in his armpit. And if Connally, who reacts to a shot shortly after Kennedy in the Zapruder film, was in fact hit by a separate shot, it means there was more than one shooter, as Oswald's bolt-action rifle was incapable of being fired twice in such a short time.
Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country. My fellow citizens of the world, ask not what America will do for you, but what together we can do for the freedom of man.
Biggest murder of the century, and it's still open.